Hey folks, this is Paul Spica and Brandon Garnott with Spica Real Estate. And today we are coming to you live from Byron Center. We are at the Bicentennial Park, downtown Byron Center. And Brandon, why are we eating outside on video today?
Well, we're at the park, right? Just got done beating some little kids in some basketball. We did the swings already, but of course it's lunchtime, so we're eating outside because August 31st is National Eat Outside Day. So of course we had to make it a point to come out here and eat outside today. So other than being a pretty good idea, I mean, how did that start, Paul?
Well, you forgot earlier to talk about the teeter-totter. You probably didn't mention that because we did the teeter-totter, and I don't know if you can notice this on camera, I'm a little bit bigger than Brandon. He got stuck at the top of the teeter-totter, and he's probably blocking that traumatic memory from his experience. So it is National Eat Outdoors Day, and it's an unofficial holiday that nobody really knows where it began, but that's okay. We like to celebrate it nonetheless because it gives us an opportunity to eat outside. A couple thoughts were picnics began as a meal break for hunters. Sidewalk cafes started to kind of pop up in the early 1900s. And I don't know, today for us, frequently, it's out on the back porch. We pull up an umbrella or whatever, and we have a hamburger meal and some fresh cut watermelon, especially this time of year as the temperatures in the afternoon start to dip a little bit. It's not 80 or 90 degrees, it's 70, and there's, like today, there's a nice little breeze. So I don't know, it's a lot of fun. And today we're eating some of our favorite local establishment food. Brandon, what do you have there?
Yeah, so I have the number 4 from Boardwalk Subs. Got a lot of meat on it. It's a pretty big sandwich, so if you get the whole sandwich, I hope you're hungry. So I'm looking forward to diving into this later. Paul has the wimpy little Letwich there.
I do. The downside of going gluten-free is you don't get all the gluten-y goodness of the 14-inch big massive sub over here, but you do get a lot of lettuce. Hopefully my sarcasm makes it through. So I get the number 8, I think it is, number 8 or number 9, and it's basically as much meat as you can possibly get in it, which makes up for the quantity of lettuce. Anything else? We also should mention that today is also National Trail Mix Day, and I like trail mix.
And you can kind of combine the two and eat your trail mix outside, and it's like 2 for 1.
You can, exactly. You can celebrate 2 holidays at the same time. That's awesome. I think that's it.
All right. See you guys later.
Thanks. Have a great one.